Good afternoon, good evening. Praise the Lord for another day. Thank you for today. Thank you for the gift of life. Our most holy and precious Father, we thank you. It's been you all the way. The Lord has been good. The Lord has been glorious. The Lord has been faithful. It's another of my live broadcasts, and I'm so glad to come your way. God bless you all. As many who are here and as many who are coming, the Lord richly bless you. Today is the 14th day of February. Thank God for today. I have a discussion today that I want to do. My topic says, can praise do the job in my marriage? Can praise do the job in my marriage? So today we are going to be talking about that, and then let's see how it goes. What praise can do.
Lord,
the praise call is entering my phone. Please, nobody should call my phone, please. I'm on my live broadcast. Please, don't call my phone. Thank you, and God bless you. Thank you so much. Genesis chapter 1 and verse 27 says, so God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him, male and female, created he them. Praise the Lord. I want to explain a few things before we go ahead. When I read that place, I said God created man in his own image. Thank you, my friends, my sisters, my brothers, everyone that is here on this platform. The Lord bless you richly in the name of Jesus. The Bible said the Lord created man in his own image, created them male and female. So if God created him male and female, it means we have a similarity with God. You are like God in some ways. You know, for those who are parents already now, when you have your children, you see some things that your children have that they look so much like you. And then that's how it is with you too. You have so many similarities with God. God can hear your feelings. God knows your pains. God knows how you feel. When you cry, he knows. When you want something, he knows. And then if you want something from God, you tell God, I want you to give me this thing. And then he knows you are matured enough to handle what you're asking for. He doesn't stop you. He gives it to you. He has the capacity to give it to you. And then when you are also happy, God knows. And when you equally do something right, you do what is right before God, God is equally happy. I want to explain, I want to do a teaching on what I want to do. At the end of the day, today's teaching will result in us all going to have our homework. We will have our homework from this teaching today. So stay tuned and the Lord will bless you. Praise the Lord. So God has a personality. God has a feeling. If you do something nice to him, he also is impressed. When you do something wrong, he's also not happy with what you do. And that's how it is with you and I too. Me and you. You have a capacity. You can do some things. If your child says, Mommy, I want a pair of shoes, that's something you can do. You do it gladly. That's how it is with God. Praise the Lord. So, one of the things that impresses God is praise. When you praise God, God is excited. We have learned in so many teachings today in church that don't ask God anything, just praise him. And then whatever it is you are asking God, he gives it to you. Praise the Lord. Don't you think that if you equally do that in your marriage, in your home, it will also give you a result if you do praise? Praise is something that you are not really asking for anything. You are just celebrating a person. You are just telling the person how good he is, how good she is. For those of us who are married, who are listening to me, there are things that your husband does to you, and you say, oh, my beloved, thank you. My sweet honey, thank you. My sweetie pie, thank you. There are so many good names that you give to them, and then you are saying thank you, because he's a human being. That's how it is when you tell God, thank you, Lord Jesus. I just want to say thank you for doing this for me. I appreciate what you have done for me. Man is also, his heart is also being praised when you do that for him. When you do such a thing to give to man. So we are going to learn a lesson what praise can do. If praise did that then, are you sure it will not also do something for us in our homes? It will. So let's quickly go to 2 Chronicles chapter 20. I want to start from the 2 Chronicles chapter 20 and verse 1. It says, it came to pass after this also that the children of Moab and the children of Ammon and with them other besides the Amorites came against Jehoshaphat to battle. Jehoshaphat was faced with a battle. He didn't know what to do. This is not one person coming to you, more than one. They have been fighting battles before this time and he has been conquering. But on this particular time, there was another battle he was set to conquer again. He didn't know what to do. And then he went to God. What do I do? He went to the priest. How do I solve this problem? How do I resolve this? I'm so glad for everyone here. I appreciate your presence. The Lord bless you. Thank you so much. Jehoshaphat had issues. How do I resolve this? What do I do about this? And then he was finding a way to solve it. Just like in your home today, there are some things that are confronting you. You don't know what to do, especially with your husband, with your wife. So one of the things I want to talk about today is how is one of the things I can do to resolve it. So Jehoshaphat, finding a solution to the problem in his hands, he was giving an instruction of, gather the singers, come and praise. It was not time to pray. It was not time to worship. It was not offering time. It was just a time to come and sing praise. I will explain later, what was the praise all about? What were the words that was being said? How did he resolve and give them victory? Praise the Lord. So the Bible recorded that in 21, and when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, and that should praise the beauty of his holiness as they went out before the army, and to say, these are the words that were being said. There were not plenty words. Praise the Lord, for his mercies endureth forever. Those were just the words that these people were saying. I'm trying to connect it to you and I today. Praise moved God. And we know how God gave these people victory. Praise the Lord. Your husband in the house, don't you think if you praise him too, it will bring out something good from him? He's not good. He has not done what is right. But I want you to step back today. See, since I have prayed, I have fasted, you have done all of that, which is just good. But on this particular day, this is what I want you to do. The remaining 2 weeks in this month, I want you to celebrate that man. Don't insult him, don't quarrel, no fighting, but every day, say, honey, sweetie, if it's his name you call, fine, that's the way you do it. If it's, you call him to his child's name, honey, I want to tell you, I appreciate you. You are the best man that I could have married. If praise did wonders, do you know how it helped Jehoshaphat? The Bible said Moab and Ammon, they started fighting themselves. They were fighting themselves. They killed themselves. So much so that Jehoshaphat now came. The spoils, Jehoshaphat now had to have it. That's your husband that is not doing the right thing. Or the problem in the home that you want your husband to do. You know, we women, we are good to say, my husband, you know, he does not always want to hear what I say. He's always doing his own. Is that his friend that is influencing him? This is what he's always doing. I don't like what he's doing. How about you changing the pattern from today? Praise your husband. Appreciate him. Just keep telling him, oh, my dear husband, you are the best thing that happened to me. I appreciate your presence in my life. He's not doing what you want to. But when you are doing that, just like Jehoshaphat, God just told him to praise. He didn't tell him to pray. He didn't know how God caused them to be fighting themselves. Will you appreciate this man every day for the remaining 2 weeks of this month? Every day, make it a duty. And let it come from your heart, because God knows what is in your heart. Don't say, that woman says, okay, sometimes I want to speak Nigerian English, forgive me. That woman says we should appreciate our husbands. Okay, let me just say, no, you have to say it from your heart, because the Bible says he watches our heart, he sees our heart. There was a time the Israelites, they left Israel, but their heart was still in Egypt. They were no longer in Egypt, but their heart was still in Egypt. So if you say it from your heart, God knows. If you don't say it from your heart, if you say it with just your lips, God is also aware of it. He knows it. So I want you to make up your mind today and say, this battle that is confronting me, that my husband and I, we are not able to resolve it. We are not able to come to a conclusion. I want to do this part of it that I have just learned. I promise you, it's going to work. Make it a duty. Today is what they call, Valentine. You don't know that person. You are celebrating him for many years. So people are looking for how to do something special. But today, I want you to do something very special for your husband. And if you are a man watching me, you share it to your wife. From now to the end of this month, you wake up in the morning, honey, I just love you. You are not praying. You are not fasting. I just appreciate your presence in my life. You are the best. And do you know that when you say that kind of a thing, the man will first be wondering, where did he, who, is anybody advised, who told him, who told her to say that? Where did you go to? You are just doing what principle is. Let us learn an example from the Queen Esther. Queen Esther had prayed. She had fasted. She had done all that she knew to do. She wasn't praying anymore. She was telling the king, I want to cook for you. I want to make a banquet for you. She wasn't praying anymore. She had done all that she needed to do. She now needed to do this one to get the king's attention, because there is a battle ahead that she needs to conquer. Your own now, you are not, I'm not asking you to go and make food. I'm not asking you to spend money to cook food. It's just the words of your mouth. Just wake up. It may be that he's not with you. Maybe he's in another city. Send him a text message. Honey, I appreciate you every day. It's not cook food. No. Just the words of your mouth. Just like these people were saying, praise the Lord for his mercies endureth forever. If he moved God to cause their enemies to be defeated before them, it will move your husband to do the right thing. You want a situation where in your home, when you tell your husband, this is what I want, he will just do it for you. When you wake up in the morning, say, honey, I just appreciate your presence. It's an assignment. I want us to do this assignment. Even if you want to call it religiously, whichever one you want to call it, let us return the ancient landmark to our marriages. Like Sarah, whose daughters we are, he used to call her husband, my Lord. There's a way you treat my lord. There's a way you treat a king. You don't treat a king like ish anyhow. This man, he can give you, do anything for you when his heart is secure, when his heart is rejoicing. Every day for the next 2 weeks, keep doing it from your heart. Don't do it like, let me just do it. Let me see whether it's going to work. It will work. You will testify. If Esther, she did what she ought to do, did she not have a testimony? She had a testimony. The Jews that would have been killed, the whole thing was reversed. The story changed. So in your home today, you look at that challenge. You look at what is happening to you. You just know that things are not right. It's not the way it is. And your husband is not helping matters. What do I do to this man? It's not fighting him. It's not quarreling him. It's not saying I will not give you what you want. Just the words of your mouth. That's all I want you to do for the remaining 2 weeks in this month. God bless everyone that is here. The Lord bless you all. Just the words of your mouth, like the children of Israel did at that time. Praise the Lord for his mercies endures forever. In the morning, every day, make it a duty. My husband, you are the best. Because when you do this thing, it enters your spirit while you are saying it. And when you say it to him, it equally enters his spirit. We are spirit beings. When he enters his spirit, he now starts watching you, listening to you. I did one of my live broadcasts. If the woman submits to her husband without saying a word, the woman will be born again. The word of God could not change the man. But because of the character of the man now got changed. If you speak these words to your husband every day, maybe you are not talking to him, you will first start with a text message. My dear husband, I appreciate you. That's all I want us to do for the remaining days of this month. I'm going to do it as well. I say it to my husband, but I can't remember saying it every day. But I want to do it for the remaining days of this month. I want to celebrate my husband just like we celebrate other people. I appreciate you in my life. This man, I say you should appreciate. He has not done everything all right. That's not what I have said. But sow that seed every day. You are the best that happened to me. I appreciate you in my life. You are the best that happened to me. The words that you know that when you speak to him, his head is relaxed. Some of you can even call his African name that nobody knows. You can call him one name that nobody really knows he's bearing. You call him that name. I love you. You are the best thing that happened to me. I appreciate you in my life. He will first be imagining, where is she coming from? What has happened? Who told her to, are you sure she does not have a target? Are you sure something is not happening? He will first be watching you. But if you keep saying it every day, it's equally changing your mindset. It's equally changing what you are thinking. You are no longer seeing him like the wrong thing he did. You are seeing him as a different person because words that you say, the Bible says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speak. When you say it, it registers in your heart. Praise the Lord. Say good words to your husband. Not that guy that they are celebrating today. They are just celebrating. He does not know you. You don't know him. This is your husband. You know him. Celebrate him. Celebrate him. I'm not saying you shouldn't do other things, but these words of mouth, the Bible says the words that I speak, they are spirit and they are life. You don't just say words, they have life, they have power, they can heal, they can deliver, they can set you free, they can set another person free. Say the right words to him. I appreciate you. I appreciate you. You are the best thing to me. I wrote something down. Honey, you are a very good husband. Tell him, sweetheart, you are the best husband I could have married. Who? Sweetie, honey pie, sugar, you are the honey in my milk. You are the chocolate in my milk. You are the only hair in my head. You just say those words. For the remaining 2 weeks, we have an assignment to do in this 2 weeks to go. You are the best thing that happened to me. You are the best thing that happened to me. Keep saying these words. Let it keep reoccurring in your environment, in your family. Let your children hear it. Healing will come. Deliverance will come. Change will come. That thing that you are desiring for a long time, it will happen. God has capacity to do anything. Man has capacity to do some things. If you do what your husband likes, you will be amazed at the things you will see in his hands. You will be amazed at the things he will be doing. If your husband has 500 million, for instance, and you are asking for 2 million, that's the capacity he has. Are you sure he will not give it to you? He will give it to you. There are just the environment you need to create in your home to bring a balance, to bring a change, to put the devil to a back. The devil will be disappointed. How you got to have this wisdom to do this, to bring a change in your home? God wants to do beautiful things in your home. Speak these words for the remaining 2 weeks of this month. Let's go back and see what happened when Jehoshaphat did this thing as the Lord has instructed. It's in 2 Corinthians 20 and verse 30. And it says, so the realm of Jehoshaphat was quiet, for his God gave him rest round about. Every woman wants to have rest. Every woman wants to be peaceful. No matter how you try to do it, things are not the way it ought to be. You are not experiencing it how it should be. God wants to give you rest. Are you sure God just brought you here to begin to fight, struggle, work hard without a peaceful environment, without a peaceful home? No, God does not want that for you. God wants you to be happy. God wants you to be joyful. God is interested in your peace. And then you think that this man is not doing the right thing. Then do this recommendation. Do this prescription. Just like when you are sick, the doctor tell you, take this drug 3 times a day. Take it 5 times a day. Whichever time you are told to take it. This one is just once a day. This prescription of, honey, my husband, my sweetie, you are the best. And for men who will be having such experiences of a difficult wife as well, you can also do it. It can work wonders. Words of our mouth, they are powerful. Don't play with it for the remaining days of this week, the remaining days of this month. Appreciate your husband. Just say the right words to him. The enemy will be chased out 360 degrees. You will not find him. Praise the Lord. It worked for Esther when she did words. When she made a banquet for the king. The enemy's plan was averted. Your husband that is not doing what you want, how you expect it, speak these words every day to him. Speak these words. Speak the right words. And the Bible says, the words that you speak, they have power. I also want to make reference to Mark chapter 11 and verse 23. Mark 11:23. This was what helped Kenneth E. Hagin in his days, in his deathbed. For verily I say unto you that whosoever shall say to this mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea, and no doubt in his heart. Don't doubt this thing you want to do. Believe it, that those things which he said shall come to pass. He shall have whatsoever he says. Don't doubt these words that you will be speaking this time. Believe it that it will do wonders. Believe it that it will change something for you. Speak nice words to your partner, to your spouse, to your husband. God wants to cause great things to happen in your home. Beloved, it will work for you. It will work in your home. It will work wonders for you. Praise can do the job. Having prayed, having fasted, having given, having done everything within your power, you have done all that you want to do. Appreciate your husband. Appreciate your wife for those who are having difficult wives. Appreciate them. Speak the nice way. Just don't consider the wrongs or the bad or his character that is wrong. This time, just focus on just one good thing that you can remember. And just keep appreciating that thing. Appreciating it. The story will change. Praise the Lord. I'm so glad that you have all come today. And for those who will be watching this live broadcast after this time, the Lord bless you. The Lord give you grace to do it. This is on the 14th of February. For 2 weeks, do this principle. And you will see a change in your home. You will see deliverance take place. You will not need anybody to come and consult deliverance or whatever. All of those will be bye-bye stories. You have just done what moves God to make God do something for mankind. You have equally done it in your home. The story will change for the better in the name of Jesus. And for those who homes who have already been doing this thing, you will enjoy a greater measure of God's peace, a greater measure of God's blessing. For those who are experiencing ups and downs, by reason of this message today that you will be listening and doing it, your life, your marriage will experience the sweetness of heaven in the name of Jesus. For those who are not even married, as you get married, do this thing, do this principle. The Lord will cause sweetness in your home in the name of Jesus. I pray for everyone here today and after this time. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord will watch over you. The help and the mercy of God you will enjoy in the name of Jesus. The grace of God will be sufficient for you. You will conquer grounds this week. You will conquer grounds this week. The grace of God will be sufficient for you in the name of Jesus. Your home will experience the dew of heaven in the name of Jesus. The Lord bless and keep you all in the name of Jesus. I do my live broadcast every Sunday at 4 p.m. Nigeria time. Sorry, UK Nigeria time. Nigeria is 5 time. United States is 11 a.m. Join me on my live broadcast. I'm talking about marriages. The Lord wants our homes to be happy. The Lord is interested in homes. He has created us our homes to be happy. The Lord is interested in homes. He has created us to have good homes. He has not brought us here to come and struggle, pain, problem here and there. That's not why we are here. God wants us to dominate here. God wants us to rule. God wants us to continually say, God be praised. He's done marvelous things for us. I'll be bringing teaching from the Word of God that will be changing our homes, that will give us testimonies continually. Not testimonies today and tomorrow is a different story. No, we will continually have ceaseless testimonies. Testimonies uncountable. Our children will be happy. Our children will be growing up well with testimonies, with things happening. It will just be joyous all the time. The Lord bless you all and keep you. It's a good week. It's a week of breakthrough, a week of blessing, a week of good news. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Thank you for everyone that was here. I so appreciate you all. The Lord bless you all. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Thank you all. Have a great week ahead. In Jesus' name, amen. Bye. The Lord bless you.